Hello everyone. In this video, I will demonstrate how you can find your product key or a product key and how to create a USB installation with Windows and install it, then activate the product. Then I will show how to upgrade Windows to the new version.
Okay, so since Microsoft decided to discontinue Windows 7 2 years ago, it's a little bit difficult to find the ISO file on the Microsoft website, but there's still a couple of websites that you can find the ISO file and download it for free. Just be careful, some of the sites are malicious sites. Don't click on any Windows or commercials that you don't recognize. After you manage to download the ISO file, it is time to mount it on a thumb drive or a disk on key removable drive. To do that, we're going to use a free software name of Rufus. It will take the ISO file and make it bootable on the USB drive. Just click on download according to your operating system. And when the file finished to download, open it. Rufus, when putting the image on the disk on key, it's going to delete everything, so if you need something, it's time to copy it to another location, so you will have a backup of your file. In the device, we need to make sure that the thumb drive is checked. Then we need to browse and select the ISO file. We can change the name for the CD, but it's not important. The software is going to warn you that the removable storage will be erased. Click OK. The software now is writing the ISO file to the thumb drive. When it's done, you can close the window and it's time to take out the removable media and put it in the new computer. A lot of computers are already configured to boot from the removable media first. But if not, you can try to get into the boot menu by rapidly pressing a key. This key changes from computer to computer. You can search with Google according to your manufacturer of the motherboard. When you successfully boot into the removable media, you will see this screen. I decided to install Windows 7 because of demonstration purposes. It's easier to find product key for this version. So to begin the installation, click install now. Accept the terms. Of course, read it thoroughly, it's very important. Choose the custom advanced. So in this window, you will delete all the partitions and leave the hard disk with only one space. So now Windows is expanding the files and will install all the necessary items for it to run. I chose to start with Windows 7 because it's the most difficult operating system to install these days. I think it's the best operating system came out from Microsoft throughout this day. Type a name and a password. It's not master password, but it's recommended. So now that you have Windows installed, let's check out the activation status. After a few minutes, you will see the watermark on the right bottom side said the Windows is not genuine and you need to activate it. You can check the status in the properties. And what you need to do is to change the product key. So the product key you can find on the outside case, if it's a station or if it's a laptop, you turn it upside down and usually there will be a sticker with the product key. Many times big organization leaving the sticker on the case but are not really using the product key, so they use another product key from the license server or whatever, and this key is it's possible to activate Windows with this key. In this case, Windows failed to activate this because network is not configured. The easiest way to find information about your network card is to go to device managers and check for the hardware ID. Then Google the hardware ID and get information about your network card, and it's easier to find the driver this way. Now when I put the product key, I get another error message. This is because an important service pack is missing. So you need to download the KB. Need to restart the machine and wait for the installation to finish. Now when you try to activate with the product key, you will get activation was successful. Now your Windows is genuine. So most of the users will not want to stay with Windows 7 and want to upgrade to Windows 10 or 11. So the best and easiest way to do this is to use the media creation tool. Download it from Microsoft. You might get lucky, and after running this tool, your Windows will change from Windows 7 to Windows 10, and you will need no more activation or product number to provide for Microsoft. But for me, I failed to run this tool, probably because of some protocols missing in my Windows 7. I just installed it. No updates or whatever. So I'm going to download the ISO for Windows 10 and do an in-place upgrade. Again, if you're having trouble finding the ISO file in the internet for downloading, please let me know in the comments. I will try to help. To open image file, ISO file in Windows 7, you need another software. And our software is wincdemu. You can download for free from the internet. I will post a link in the description. after the download finish, install the software. So navigate to your ISO file that you just downloaded and mount it on a drive. Then you will see the setup.exe file. Double click it or run it as an administrator, even better. And setup will suggest you to upgrade your Windows to Windows 10. From here, it's pretty straightforward. You just follow the all the questions, click next whenever is needed. If you see the letter N, you don't want that. This is something to do with North Korea. It's very limited Windows. Click accept. Then when it's ready, click install. And in about 10 to 15 minutes, your Windows will be ready. I'm using the same username and password from my Windows 7 installation to log in. But now, when I log in, I will see a welcome screen. So here, Windows suggests a privacy setting. You should read it before accepting. Now we go ahead and check our activation status. In some cases, Windows will think that the hardware has been changed due to driver compatibility and will ask you to activate again. So this is how to find your product key and install Windows on your machine. Thank you for watching.